guys, how are you all today? Welcome back to my channel.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I please have your attention? And I need all of you to stop what you're doing and listen.
In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how you can look a lot better without using makeup. Now, if you're someone like me who loves using makeup, you do you. Nothing against makeup. I personally love makeup. I think it's so therapeutic to just do stuff on my face and, you know, just play around with colors. But for the longest time, I wasn't allowed to wear makeup, and for a lot of people, they don't like wearing makeup. So this is completely like your own personal choice whether or not you want to use makeup. But I, over the past few years, have collected a couple of tips and tricks on how you can look really gorgeous and really, really nice without using too much of makeup. I remember early on in the morning when I was going to college, I did not feel like doing a full face. Or, you know, in college, you don't generally apply makeup. It's just too much for college. So I just used to do a couple of these things and just head out. Like, this would be my routine. So I just wanted to share it today with you guys, and hopefully this is going to benefit you. My first tip for you is to understand your face shape and your undertone. Face shape is important to understand what kind of haircut would look good on you. I know a lot of people go to parlors and say, I want this exact hairstyle. They show a picture of an actress or a model, and sometimes it does not end up looking good on your face. So this is why understanding what kind of face cut you have is important. Here is a picture of a few of the most common face cuts, so you can see which one kind of resembles yours and accordingly search for hairstyles that will suit your face shape. Your hair literally shapes your face. It's what goes around your face when your hair is in front, and you want that to look literally perfect. Think of it this way: you click a very beautiful picture, but then you just put the wrong filter on top of it. That filter can make your picture look really bad or really good. So make sure you use the right filter, and in this case, that means make sure you choose the right haircut according to your face shape. Understanding your undertone is really important, because this is what will help you decide what kind of accessories will look good on you. Now, I'm sure you've heard people say, I prefer gold jewelry to silver, or I prefer silver jewelry instead of gold. The reason they have these individual likings is because of the way that color looks against their skin. So for me, I know I love silver colored jewelry, silver plated jewelry. The easiest way to see what will suit your undertone is to first know what your undertone is. Now, this you can do by looking at the veins right here. So if you have more of olive colored undertones, usually traditional gold or yellow would look really nice. And if you have more of blue or purple colored undertones, it's said that silver colored jewelry would look good on you. So that's just an assumption, of course. Some people have neutral undertones, and for them it's like the best of both worlds, but you see what works for you. This was just a little heads up from my side. Next is hairstyling. Now, gone are the days when that messy hairdo would look good. According to me, at least, there was a phase when all of us were like into that whole crumbled hairstyle, but I feel now that phase has long gone. Now I would prefer more of a sleek, a nice look, a neater look. So either a center parting or a nice neat side parting that you can see right now, you know, like sleek hair. I don't want to go for that unkempt look now. I think it just adds a lot more class and a lot more poise to the entire outfit. Even if you're wearing a really simple outfit, if your hair is neatly done, it instantly adds grace to the outfit and makes you look put together, basically. If you have stray hair flying, I would highly recommend buying hair clips. You can get a ton of them, hair accessories, hair clips. You can use hair bands. I bought a few myself from H&M. I will leave links down below in case you want to buy. They're very easily available on H&M, Amazon, Shein, wherever you want to buy, honestly. The point is to make your hair look neat and tidy and not messed up, you get it? A very famous makeup artist once said that the best makeup product you can put on your face is a good night's sleep. And in case you have not been able to catch up on sleep, if you're very busy, though right now is the perfect time to catch up on sleep, but in case you're very busy, just use this small hack and it will literally transform your life. Take a spoon, put it in the freezer overnight, and take it out in the morning. The spoon is going to be really cold. Just press it under your eye bags and just do this for a little while and see the magic for yourself. Your under eye bags will start curing because of the coolness. If this does not work, try using tea bags. Again, just put tea bags in the freezer, take it out after a while and put those. This will not show immediate results, but over time you will see your eye bags will just be, they'll be gone, they won't even be there. Because a lot of people ask me, how do you do this? I use the teaspoon thing so much. The next one is shaping your eyebrows with coconut oil and a brush. Now, the first time I got my eyebrows done was in, I think, 9th grade. Before that, my eyebrows were really bushy. And now again, you can see I haven't done my eyebrows since quite some time because of the lockdown. I haven't done it, and you can see they're still bushy, but I do obviously want to tame them. I don't want them to be, again, really messy. Just like your hair, you have to take care of your eyebrow hair as well. So one hack that I found out very recently is you just take a little bit of coconut oil and just take a little bit. You don't want to take too much. Just put it over your eyebrows. Just to let you know, I don't have any makeup on right now. So you can see this is like my bare skin. Just take any eyebrow pencil. I use the Benefit Goof Proof eyebrow pencil with this spoolie at the end and just shape your brows. I will leave a link to this down below as well. Give them the shape that you want to go for. Even if you do get your eyebrows done, I think coconut oil still really helps. You can use any oil, to be very honest, but just make sure you get a spoolie or an eyebrow brush and just kind of shape it so it looks more put together, it looks more groomed. So eyebrows are really important when it comes to shaping your face, so please make sure you do this one. Now I keep telling you guys about products that I'm trying out during the day, what new products, what new face washes I'm trying out, but I have an entire night care routine which is completely separate. I don't want to make a whole video on this, and I will sometime in the future, but as of now I just want to tell you about some really cool products that I'm trying out as a part of my night routine. Now as always, having a nice glow is really important. You can get this through a highlighter, of course, but what actually makes all the difference is having an internal glow, having that glow from within. Of course, a highlighter is there. I mean, that's what makeup is for. But if you have that glow from within, and imagine on top of that, if you put a highlighter, if at all you want to put it, imagine like it's going to be double the glow. Now, vitamin C as a nutrient is very essential for immunity. And similarly, vitamin C is also really, really important when it comes to skincare and your skin's immunity. Now, after an entire day's work, I like to wash my face, obviously. And at night, I've been using the vitamin C face wash from Mama Earth. And this has vitamin C and turmeric, and it is really, really good for skin's illumination. It obviously gets rid of dirt, impurities, lethargy, but at the same time, it brightens your skin. It helps you repair your skin by boosting collagen production and improving your blood circulation, which leaves you with really nice, radiant, glowy skin from within. If you're looking for a really nice everyday kind of face wash, I think this is perfect because it removes all those impurities, the dirt, the excess oil that's there. At the same time, it retains moisture and is good for all skin types. Vitamin C fights sun damage and provides radiance. Turmeric has anti-inflammatory and antiseptic properties, and it protects the skin naturally. Aloe vera has excellent antimicrobial, anti-inflammatory and skin healing properties. Turmeric also treats acne. Vitamin C combats photo aging and boosts collagen production. I've also been trying out a sleeping mask from the same range, and oh my god, you guys, a sleeping mask I never knew the importance of. I was just like, what is so special about it, until I used it, because honestly, you've got to see my glow. It doesn't matter whether you're at home or whether you're working the entire day, you're still exposed to UV rays, to dirt, to pollution, and of course, harsh weather conditions. Now, to combat it all, what I have found is using this at night. So all you do is take a little bit, apply it at night, and just go off to sleep. In the morning, you wake up and you look at your face, you will see the glow. The thing is, all of these stressors, all of these harsh weather conditions, they all cause your skin to lose its radiance. You can use the most expensive highlighter, it will not work if your skin is not glowing from within. This is why I'm saying, usually raat ko hum log kya karte, we just wash our face and we go off to sleep, or maybe apply a moisturizer at the most. Give it some extra love at night and try to use this. Now throughout the night when you're sleeping, what this does is it will replenish your skin's radiance. It will give you that boost again. This also reduces pigmentation. It gives your skin a lot of hydration. Of course, it illuminates the skin. Vitamin C is known for that. It's known for glow and radiance. So just get yourself one and see the magic for yourself. Apart from that, you guys know all Mamaearth products are natural and chemical free, cruelty free, PETA certification they've got. Vitamin C helps reduce signs of aging and keeps your skin looking even and hydrated, and aloe vera aids in treating inflamed, sunburnt, and sensitive skin. Now, these products are just a part of the range. Apart from this, they also have a face mask, a toner, and a skin illuminating serum. You can go and check out the entire range on Amazon, on Nykaa, and on mamaearth.in. And if you want to buy anything from mamaearth.in, you can use the code GROWER2020 and get yourself a 20% off. One last thing that I want to let you guys know is that Mamaearth is a plastic positive company, which means they recycle more plastic than they use. And I think that is such a sustainable way of living. So if you want to give these products a try, the links will be down below, so make sure you check the description box out as well. Now moving on, if you can't use a blush or a lipstick, the best thing you can do is get yourself a tinted lip balm. Now lip balms are really good, especially for nourishing and hydrating your lips. So all you have to do is get a tinted lip balm and of course just apply it onto your lips. I just take a little bit on my fingers and just kind of go over my lips. But take the same thing and just apply it to your cheeks as well and kind of dab it a little. And your cheeks also just get a little bit of love and care. So just, you know, pamper yourself. You can do this if you want to add a little more color. If you're not allowed to use bronzer or blush or something like that. Or if you just don't want to use it, allowed kya matlab agar nahi use karna, This is always a nice little thing you can do. And finally, please make sure you're taking care of your body from within. Upar se to ye sab you're doing, and that's good. I mean, of course, you know, take care of your eyebrows, take care of your hair, make sure everything's groomed and nice. But if your body is not feeling good from within, it will reflect outside. So many times when I'm stressed, I start having stress acne. I mean, your skin is a reflection of whatever's happening inside your body. So might as well take care of it. Give yourself good food, please. Balance it out, cut down on junk, and start having more of vegetables, you know. Trust me, more water, more vegetables always help. I have this bottle that I've kept with me at all times. I finish 2 liters a day. It helps regulate my PCOD problem. The more junk you put into your body, the more harm you're doing. My point here being balance is the key, and if you're having junk, it's fine, but just balance it out with healthy food as well. Don't take your body for granted. Treat it like a temple. You don't want to dirty your temple. You don't want to dirty your body either. So of course, nourish your skin. I spoke about skincare. I spoke about skincare routines. Similarly, nourish your body with good things. Those were all the ways that you can look good without using makeup. I hope this video was informative and you learned something from it. As always, links will be down below of all the products that I used. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Let me know what other videos you want to watch. If you're new here, please subscribe to the channel. I would love that. I will see you guys next time. But before I leave, I just want to let you know I go live on Instagram very often. My ID is right over here, and I would love for you to join the family. I post a lot of OOTDs. We have chit chats very often, so check it out, see if you like it, and I am gonna see you all next time. Till then, bye bye.